corruption allegations against FIFA for a long time.
To put it mildly, there have been corruption allegations for a great many years. Stephanie, much of that is connected to how FIFA decides which nations get to host the popular, highly coveted World Cup every 4 years. Now, this FBI investigation looked into the multi-billion dollar juggernaut, even though most of those arrested are not U.S. citizens.
Early Wednesday morning in Zurich, Swiss law enforcement went to the rooms of six top soccer officials at the posh Bar-a-Lac Hotel and arrested them on U.S. federal corruption charges.
This for FIFA is good. It's not good in terms of image. It is not good in terms of reputation, but in terms of cleaning up, in terms of everything what we did in the last 4 years, in terms of the reform process, this is good.
And that apparently was just the start. The Justice Department is charging 14 people with racketeering and conspiracy, 9 of them FIFA officials. The Justice Department also issued a search warrant for the Miami headquarters of CONCACAF, soccer's governing body in the U.S., Central America, and the Caribbean. CONCACAF's current president, Jeffrey Webb, was among the indicted. A key element of the DOJ's case, guilty pleas unsealed this morning, one of them from a former U.S. representative to FIFA's executive committee. The most prominent of the names on the list of indictments is Jack Warner of Trinidad and Tobago. He's a former FIFA executive committee member who's been accused of numerous ethical violations over the years, including receiving millions of dollars of misappropriated funds, illegal reselling of 2006 World Cup tickets, and scheming to buy votes in FIFA's 2010 presidential election. FIFA President Sepp Blatter is not reported to be among those set to face charges. However, the arrest in Switzerland took place just 2 days before Blatter was expected to be re-elected to a fifth term as FIFA's president. The question now is, will these arrests leave Blatter vulnerable to his only competition for FIFA's presidency, Jordan's Prince Ali bin Al Hussein?
He has been there for 17 years. And it's time now that we have proper transparency and proper reform.
The Swiss government has agreed to extradite the six arrested in Zurich Wednesday to the U.S. to face their charges.
But those arrested today have the right to challenge the extradition requests. And that means it could be a long time before any of them stand trial in a U.S. court. Now, Attorney General Loretta Lynch is set to speak about the charges in just a few hours. And as for the 2018 World Cup in Russia and the 2022 competition in Qatar, FIFA said this morning, as of now, those games will go on as planned, Stephanie.
Okay, John Henry Smith, thank you.